got caught with a kilo. And if you ever do, you'll never be with me. Yo, serve it in the pan. I got caught with a kilo. And if you ever do, you'll never be with me.
What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to another episode of Dauntless Outdoors. Today's episode, we're diving with Ollie and Drake. We are in like 120 foot of water. It's pretty foggy out here. Goal is to shoot some fish, probably APs and stuff. So we're gonna hop in the water, catch you in the water. What's going on, y'all? I just hopped in the water and we are in about 120 foot, maybe closer to 130. I think I did a one bottom drop throughout this whole day, and it was 128 on my watch. So it kind of just depends on where you land. But this is my first dive of the day. I'm headed down. I knew I wasn't going to the bottom here, but I was thinking I might be able to line up on an African pompano or an American red snapper. So I get down here to about 75, 80 foot, and I spot a couple nice American reds, and I decided I was going to take the shot on this one here on the right. Waited for him to turn a little bit, and then I took the shot. Landed a super good holding shot, so I knew I could just grab him and swim on up to the surface. So I landed a shot on that fish and threw it in the boat. And as soon as I did that, I told Drake there was a bunch more of them down there, so he dropped down to about 85 feet here and decided he was going to take a shot on this closer one that was a little bit bigger than the farther one. So, as you can tell, lands a beautiful shot and brings the fish up to the surface, landing his first American red of the day. So after Drake landed that fish, he told me there's a couple more down there, and I ended up going a little bit deeper than where he told me to, just because I didn't see any at that depth. So I got down here to about 100, 105 foot, and as I'm sitting here, I look over and I spot a fish we don't really see that much of. It's a Kubera snapper. You can zoom in or go back a little more, and you'll see that there was about a 25 pounder, really nice fish. Kind of wish I could have got a shot on him, but unfortunately, he's a little bit too smart. So I got to the surface, told Drake about my fish that I just saw, and told him he might get a shot if he could go down there. So he goes down here. He's at about 85, 90 foot again, and unfortunately he didn't see that fish. We didn't see the fish for the rest of the day, but as you can tell, bunch of nice American red snapper. Now he just has to decide which one he wants to take. So he's sitting here waiting for the biggest of the school to show up and spots the one he likes, takes his shot, and completely stones the fish. So swims it back up to the surface and lands his second fish of the day. So Drake landed that American red and he got back in the water and started diving. He's down here at about 90 foot. Unfortunately, the American red started pushing a little bit deeper than that, but the whole goal was to shoot some African pompano anyways. So he lines up on one of them and it's giving him a pretty bad shot, but he takes it anyways, lands it about the middle of the body, and he wants to make sure he's going to land this fish, so he comes back up to the surface and requests a backup. So Drake gets up to the surface and I'm right next to him, so he tells me he's got a decent shot, but he wants to make sure he's going to land this fish because these fish are worth about $5 a pound, and losing a fish of this caliber, which is about 30 to 35 pounds, is about $150 or more. So I go down here and I make sure he's going to land this fish by shooting it right through the head, and we pull it up to the surface.
You have a good shot.
After that encounter, Drake told Ollie that there was a good bit more of them down there. So Ollie did a drop, and he went down to about 90 foot again, and landed a pretty bad shot on one of these fish. It unfortunately pulls off here, and I do a drop, hoping to somehow bump into this fish, but unfortunately, I did not see that fish, and all I saw was amberjacks. So I had to go back up to the surface and break the news to Ollie.
so sad.
So I get back up to the surface and I'm calming down, catching a couple breaths, and I look down and I see that African pompano. So I knew I had to drop down. He's down here at about 50 foot. I wait until I get a really good shot that I knew I wasn't gonna miss. Absolutely smoke him, goes through his head, and I knew I could just pull him up to the surface with me.
That's your fish.
That's
good, man. You're
bigger than my last one.
Yeah, that's a high five. Good job.
So I get to the surface, we get that fish in the boat, and now I'm headed back down towards the bottom. I've got my gun reloaded, and I'm feeling good. They were telling me they both shot theirs around 80, 90 foot, so I knew I was good to go down there and hopefully line up on one of them. So, kind of dissenting, and I don't know if you heard it, but I did a couple calls, like grouper calls, on my way down, which a lot of people will wait until they're all the way down there to do them, but it can save you a lot of time if you do them on your way down, as like if you're hunting pelagics or middle of the water column fish, just because you don't waste that much more time to attract the fish to you. But as you can see, it worked. I got my first shot on that African pompano and I was pretty stoked.
Josh, just got back in the boat, did a pretty deep dive and shot him really far away, like the end of the line wrap, and still got him, went clean through him, probably, I don't know, 25, maybe 30 pound AP, definitely a nice one, so we're going to hop back in, hopefully get another.
Now I hop back in the water, and I noticed Ollie had another one on, so I go down here. Because earlier that fish that he shot with single flopper shaft ripped off, and I'm shooting a double flopper, which gives me a lot more grab on the fish and allows that fish to actually stay put. So get a backup shot and land this fish.
I hook and lined him.
So I helped Ollie with that fish, and it was my turn to go back down. So I'm diving to about 90 to 100 foot here. He told me that's about the depth range he shot his fish, and there was a good bit more of them. So I'm headed down, and it typically takes about 30 to 45 seconds to get to that depth range. It depends on what fins you're wearing, how much weight you have, what wetsuit and all that stuff, but that's just generally how long it takes me to get down there. And if you noticed in those first couple clips when I zoomed in, I can do that on all the clips if you guys want. I personally think it makes it a little bit easier for you guys to see the fish, but just let me know down in the comment section if that's actually helpful. So I get down here to about 80, 90 foot, and I don't know if you can hear it just yet, but I do a couple grunts, and I'm doing those right before I'm getting down to depth just so I can attract those fish a little bit earlier, and it really does save you a good bit of time and energy just because you don't have to stay there down as long. But as you can tell, there's no shortage of African pompanos. There's probably about 8 to 10 of them, but this one here is the biggest one that I spotted. Take a really good shot, and I know that fish could really never pull off just because of where I hit it, and if it were to pull off, it would be dead anyways. So I kind of let him take some line. This can be a little risky if you're in a little bit of shallow water, just because they will wrap up on structure. But when you're in about 130 foot like we are, that typically won't happen just because those fish don't swim down there. And also, they don't want to tear themselves up. So I landed that fish, and I told Drake there was a ton more of them. So he heads down there, and as you can tell, there is about, I don't know, 8 or so still left. There's a good bit more that we just couldn't get close enough to, but there was one pod that wasn't that smart and they would still let us get close. And that's what he's closing in on here. Takes a shot that he knows really good and it's just not going to pull off. So he heads up to the surface and starts tugging. So it's game on. I've already got two APs. We are doing a commercial trip, by the way. If you don't know, the recreational limit is two per person per day and also two per boat. So if you shoot two fish, two African pompano, and your buddy wants to shoot another on a recreational trip, he can't. But since we're doing commercial, you can shoot. I'm pretty sure it's unlimited, but I'm not exactly sure on that. But as you saw, landed a nice holding shot on that fish, and that's Ollie going down just to try and help me swim up to the surface and pull that fish up. So get up here, catch a couple breaths, and start pulling. Landed my third one of the day. So Ollie didn't shoot at my fish, so he had a loaded gun, and he went down, shot a cobia. I think it's a couple dives later, but I could tell his shot wasn't all the way through it. He said he took a pretty far shot at like 115 foot. So I want to make sure he's going to land it. Alrighty, y'all. We're doing pretty good. I think I've got my third AP. The box is looking pretty good. The box is looking pretty nice. Ollie just got a pretty good cobia. That was fun to say the least. That was really, really sick. All right, that's what that close is. But Drake just shot either a Kubera or a nice American red that is tied off to the fleet. And in the wreck at like 120, probably 125. So I'm gonna breathe up for a little bit and go see if I can get the fish out of there. So catch in the water. So this is Drake's cam real quickly. He's headed down here and this is the American red he takes a shot on. He takes a little bit of a farther shot and I think he was around 100 foot. So especially when you're this deep, you kind of want to put some pressure on the fish, but he was kind of pushing it here just because he followed that fish for a while, and also I think he was sitting there for a while before that he even noticed the fish was there. So no worries, that fish got tangled up and it was my turn to go down. So I'm headed down here, and as you can tell, that shaft got strung all the way through the wreck, and unfortunately that fish did rip off, but it's not that big of a deal. Typically these shafts are about $80 to $150, depending on what type of shaft you have. So it's definitely still worth the dive. So I recover this shaft. Unfortunately, I didn't see that Kubera I saw earlier in the video. I was hoping I might be able to see him and do another drop for him, but he wasn't down there. So what can you do? But as you can tell, I'm about 60 foot down, and Ollie meets me just to make sure I'm going to get up safely. So, got back up to the surface. My gun was still unloaded from the cobia spiel, and reloaded my gun, took another about 8 minute break, and then went down here and saw a really nice African pompano. He was pretty far away, so I wanted to make sure I got a good shot on him. Lined up really slowly and took the shot. So, fish freaks out, goes way off into the distance, but I knew I had a solid shot, so I could pull on him. So, and in my fourth one of the day.
Jesus Christ.
Soggy shins. Soggy foot sinking.
Alright. Straight sinking.
Nice day. It is, I think, just about 6 o'clock, maybe 5 o'clock, I don't know. We'll see whenever we get back. The clocks are all messed up on this boat, so. We're headed back in. It's a pretty calm day. I think we got 11 African pompano, and then we got 5 American reds, and a mang that you guys didn't see on video, but I'm sure I covered that, so. I'll probably catch you at the house with some fish, so see you there.
Good morning. We're offloading some fish. That was fun.
Probably the end of the vid right there.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, hit that like button, subscribe. We'll catch you in the next one.